Hare Krishna. Taking advice from vise binds us in the vise of vise. Vise refers to an object which can clasp, which can trap. So if somebody, sometimes a wrestler catches the other person in a tight grip that cannot be broken, that's called a vise-like grip. Now, vise also refers to the lower desires within us. People who have a lot of vices are vicious. Normally, when we are to move forwards in our life, we take advice from the different people. It's critical that we take advice from the right person. If we take advice from vice, that means if we take inputs from our lower desires and we consider them to be trustworthy, to be wise, then we will be ruined. We wonder, why would anyone take advice from vice? The Bhagavad Gita cautions that vice corrupts not just our senses and our mind, it also corrupts our intelligence. In the third chapter, Krishna says that Indriyani mano buddhir asyadhishthanam uchyate etair vimohayatyesha jnanamavritya dehinam. That the self-defeating desires such as lust, anger, greed, they are situated even in our intelligence. And from there, they delude us. So, for example, some people who are intelligent but who are also attached, who are also addicted, they often use their intelligence to try to find out ways in which they can indulge without getting caught. Or they may rationalize, actually this is not a big problem. And they may minimize and trivialize whatever wrongs they are doing. So for doing their wrongs and for justifying their wrongs, they take advice from their intelligence, which is corrupted by vice. And thus they take advice from vice. When they take advice from vice, the result is that they indulge more and more, and with every indulgence, their addiction becomes stronger and stronger. So thus they get caught in the vice of vice. And what is the solution to this? Two verses later in the third chapter, Krishna says in 3.43, Evam buddhe param buddhva samsthabhyatmanam atmana jahi shatrum mahabaho kamarupam durasadam. He says we need to raise our intelligence, spiritualize our intelligence, use our intelligence to situate ourselves at the spiritual level. And then we will be able to resist the allurements, the deceptions of vice. The whole message of the Bhagavad Gita is meant to provide us the wisdom by which we can spiritualize our intelligence and spiritualize our consciousness. Thus, when we learn to take advice from Krishna in the Gita, instead of from the vice that is present in our consciousness, then we can become elevated and liberated. Thank you. Hare Krishna.